Namaste, football fans and Chelsea fans. How you doing? You alright? Welcome back to Football Therapy. Welcome to another Chelsea news video where we'll be talking about something that's riddling the Chelsea headlines around football media this morning, and that is a new striker target. Apparently, one that Frank Lampard is very interested in and looks like he could be a valuable acquisition if we are to believe the news story itself and the rumoured price tag of £20 million. Interesting story indeed. I also want to talk about if Chelsea only buy two more players, and at that, not relatively top tier players as well. I want to ask you guys what you think of the team. How well can it do with the right coaching and the right team chemistry being, I don't know, nurtured together? I'm going to run through just say players in the positions, and I'm going to leave up to you guys what you think, how you feel, can we do it, is everything going to be all right, etc. So I'm looking forward to getting into this one today, but quickly, you there, please do subscribe if you've not yet subbed to Football Therapy. Just click the button, takes a second, and you wanna help me out? Do you wanna help me out? Because that would be nice. Can you like the video? Cheers, all right then. Yeah, let's get on with it. So, as you know, I look through football headlines daily, searching through the mud of nonsense, lies, and rumors, and hopefully a few scraps of truth, and I sort of gather the information, present it to you guys here on the channel. Apparently, Chelsea Football Club, Frank Lampard, the gang, Kranjskaya, Petacek, whoever's interested is looking at a new striker alternative. No, it's not a top tier elite Galactico Timo Werner vibe, but very much is a backup to Tammy Abraham slash youngster who could potentially challenge the player. But no, it's not a Moussa Dembele at £80 million, no. It's £20 million rated Gianluca Waldschmidt. Luca Waldschmidt for short, apparently. 23-year-old German forward is rated at £20 million from his club Freiburg. He can play in pretty much any attacking position, lots on the right, loads across attacking midfield, and indeed as a forward, as a striker, who apparently is very good at holding up the ball, a very, 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 very important attribute in Premier League football indeed. Now, he hasn't played much this season. Apparently, he does have trouble with injury, but generally, he looks very promising. 5 goals and 1 assist this season in the Bundesliga, 6 goal involvements in about 850 minutes. When you don't have that much time on the clock and you still can put in 6 goal involvements, that's pretty darn good considering, especially that how he's generally very highly rated makes it more promising. For example, in the under 21 Euros where he featured at, he did a madness. In just 5 appearances, he scored 7 goals and registered 1 assist. Rated very, very highly as a German international, loads of people are comparing him to some greats. Granted, he's not like a 17, 18 year old coming up, he's early 20s, but still, people have very, very high hopes for him. And if he can be caught by Frank Lampard to bring into the Chelsea team for as little as £20 million, that could be a superb acquisition. A superb acquisition because obviously Chelsea are in pretty good shape with Tammy Abraham, but we know he needs backup. We know that Giroud, although he has had a good time in the latter stages of this season when he finally got back into the team, he's still pushing for a long-term contract at a relatively big club, even though he does love Chelsea. You know, 3-year contract at Inter or something like that. I think he'll probably go for that. He won't stay at Chelsea, I think. And obviously with Michy Batshuayi, Frank Lampard doesn't fancy him, as so many Chelsea managers haven't. Now, I'm not going to crack open the can of worms of Batshuayi now. I'm just saying they both could be off. Chelsea do rate Armando Broja, but you need 3 strikers, and you can't put pressure on Broja to come in and just play centre forward all the time if Tammy's out. You need someone a little bit more talented, so Luca could be your boy. Think about it, we know the transfer window is, well, we don't know anything about the transfer window at the moment. What we do know is clubs are going to have less money. It's going to be weird, peculiar market. The whole landscape of transfers could change. If Chelsea could sneak a talented youngster, well, he's not even a talented youngster, he's a talented player who's relatively young, into their squad, who they think can score goals, who they think can challenge Tammy Abraham. If Frank Lampard does indeed want him, as the reports are suggesting, they're just reports in the media, that's all I'm saying, then great, could be a superb buy. It's not all about spending 100 million on a player that could prove more of a risk than maybe getting a gem for 20 million. So this is the part of the video where I wanted to go into like a theoretical thing. I want to talk about if Chelsea don't do mega business in the transfer market because of the market going peculiar. So just say they sign another striker because they want another striker, like a backup slash quite decent striker, and they sign a left back. Two problem positions. So for the sake of this video, I'm going to say they sign Alex Telles, that we know they're in negotiations for signing, and they sign this backup striker. Now we could say Moussa Dembele, or we could say Schmidt. I'm going to say they sign Luca Waldschmidt. I don't know why I just called him Schmidt. Maybe that's like his nickname. Waldschmidt. Let's call him Luca. They sign Luca, just say. It's a theoretical exercise. How well can Chelsea do without these like mega, mega marquee signings? Let's go through it. In terms of goalkeeper, it's going to be a difficult one. We're going to have to assume Kepa stays. Again, talented goalkeeper. We've talked about him before. Jamie coming as a backup. Maybe Aloni coming back. Three goalkeepers. Already touch and go on the goalkeeper front. But still, we can put some youngsters in there. The left back position can be populated by both Alex Telles and Ian Mattson, and that's assuming we do sell both Emerson and Alonso, who have both been heavily linked with exits from Chelsea. Point being, Mattson has signed a new long-term contract and backs his ability to be the backup at Chelsea. And of course, Chelsea are indeed looking for a new starting left back. So say them too. Of course, at right back, we've got Reece James starting, very powerful player indeed. And going behind him and rotating with him, we can use Azpilicueta, which is a very good option indeed to have as a backup rotational right back. Captain, maybe not as good as he used to be, but a very good player indeed. Now, you noticed I'm saying only a left back and a striker, which would mean Chelsea would have to stick with their current four centre backs in Kurt Zouma, Fikayo Tomori, Andreas Christensen, Antonio Rudiger, and perhaps the involvement of Ethan Ampadu. I know people say DM, centre back, whatever. I personally think he's excellent at centre-back. He could be like a fifth-choice centre-back or someone else to come in. You could even add Mark Gerhey in there if he's that highly rated, and then perhaps Chelsea do sell one centre-half. But that's who they've got on the roster. The midfield speaks for itself, and N'Golo Kante, who wants to stay at Chelsea, Jorginho, Kovacic, Loftus-Cheek, Mason Mount, Billy Gilmore, who was absolutely doing a madness before the season halted. Tino Andrin as a cam. You know, Ziyech and Pulisic as a cam, if you want. Ross Barkley as well. He'd been playing well when he was put next to Billy Gilmore. Frank Lampard won't forget that. Loads and loads and loads and loads and loads of midfielders. So, strikers, Tammy Abraham, Armando Broja, and let's just say Waldschmidt as well. This sort of middle tier young striker to challenge Tammy. And when it comes to wingers, Chelsea's four wingers would have to be Hudson-Odoi, Pulisic, Hakim Ziyech, and with no new signings and the exit of both Willian and Pedro, Mason Mount as the fourth rotational winger, being four, well, you need four wingers, that would be four wingers. As well as, you know, I'm sure there's another player that could be pushed out there. Tino Andrin could probably play in the front three as well. There would be options. So there's loads and loads of players on Chelsea's roster that can play in the first team next season. And you've got the added quality, you've got the seasoned players, you've got more of a developed style, coaching philosophy, players, team chemistry, all that sort of stuff. Frank Lampard would have had, you know, really important learning experiences this season on the pitch and off. Hopefully things can be a little bit more settled. Chelsea have played incredibly well with their current players that they've got against the top teams. So with more time, more coaching, like I said, generally being more settled, how can that squad that I've just reeled off to you do next season? If they do settle and they figure out some problems and find out the best starting 11, maybe best two starting 11s, can they challenge for trophies? I think personally they can be more consistent and be comfortably in the top four. I think City might be better under Pep Guardiola, but I think third and fourth are really gagging out for someone to be really settled in the top four. You know, Leicester dropped off this season. I think Chelsea really have the opportunity to develop what is a bunch of really talented players and just basically show that the academy have this quality, that know how to play in English football. Show that Hakim Ziyech, Pulisic have chance to shine. Do you know what I mean? Alex Tellez can really fill a left-back position, problem position at Chelsea. Do you see what I'm saying? But I do want to get everyone's opinions, because a lot of people are constantly shouting out for, we need this player, we need this player, we need this player. But maybe with a couple of signings, like problem position signings, I want to know what everyone thinks. How well do you think that squad could do next season in the Premier League, in the Champions League? Can you see really positive things for Chelsea? Get down in the comment section below and let me know your thoughts and opinions on that. A little shout out to Jan's Yard and my FIFA 20 Chelsea career mode. It's really fun. Every single day I'm doing live streams at the moment and we're doing Chelsea career mode, and you guys have been helping me out in terms of getting better at FIFA, who we buy on the transfer market, what tactics and formations we do, who, you know, what teams we put out. It's loads and loads of fun. So make sure you swing by Jan's Yard every day at 6 p.m. to come and help me on FIFA. The link to the channel is in the top of the description, so make sure you subscribe to that. If you've enjoyed the content today on this channel, please do like the video, it helps me out a lot. That's it from me, guys. Enjoy the football that's not happening, and I'll see you later. Way so tough with that bad boy tuck. I'ma get it how I'm living, I'ma walk the walk. Outline my lines, I rap through thought. Body bag the verse, outline the chalk. In my life seen trouble, hustle on the double. Silence on the trigger like my pick got a muzzle. Yo chick like to guzzle, bad boy stay in trouble. I only love this paper, sorry I don't. I love me baby.